The Digital Library is an online collection of high-quality instructional and professional learning resources available to all California public K-12 educators. It contains resources aligned with the California Common Core state standards to help educators implement the formative assessment process and improve teaching and learning.
When I was asked to review some resources for the Digital Library, I thought that would be a wonderful experience. I've always been interested in materials used in the classroom for students to help them learn. But when I really started the review, I was blown away by the high quality of the resources that I was seeing, both the professional learning resources and the instructional resources.
When I'm working with other teachers, they're often looking for resources they can implement immediately into their classrooms. And so the Digital Library is a warehouse of resources and lesson design or lesson plans that they can use immediately.
I teach high school in Northern California, and I've been using the Digital Library since it became available. I was expecting a tool with test questions and was really surprised to see that it's a library of resources for teachers to use in their classroom with their students. In addition to sample lesson plans, it has videos, modules, and so many other resources.
Well, I think the Digital Library, in the way those resources were designed, lead in teachers through the formative assessment process. And in a way, though, that it's not something added to an instructional program, it simply emphasizes when and how to do that so that it will flow freely in a classroom. You don't stop and say, okay, now we're going to elicit evidence today. Instead, this will come through in your own teaching once you get used to that.
Well, formative assessment is so vital to teaching, and knowing that there are lessons that include not only how I get the information and how I understand if my kids are being successful, but then what I do with that information after I get it.
The Digital Library has great resources for PLCs. What I think is the really nice thing about it is that if teachers are truly working in PLCs as instructional teams, where they're coming together, thinking about the standards that they're going to teach, thinking about what instructional activities, what instructional experiences they're going to use, and then how am I going to check for student understanding?
As I would see it, you know, these resources are so valuable in the Digital Library that they do touch on the things that students, particularly when you get to those higher grade levels, that students are going to need when they're out in the world of work.
Because Common Core and college and career readiness is not just within the four core, it is really the responsibility of all teachers to support their students in being able to think at a more critical level. So asking students to critique and justify and cite evidence will fit in any subject area. So there are resources on the Digital Library that support the visual and performing arts teachers, that support the business teachers, and they can pull these resources to implement in their classes to then help students cite evidence in response to a critique of a piece of art, or in a dance class, a judgment of a performance.
So whether you teach high school history, yes, content area teachers, there are resources for you. If you teach kindergarten and first grade, there are resources for you, and everywhere in between.
The site that I'm at, we've been planning for the new Common Core for about 3 years. And so by doing that, we're going on the internet, and there's just thousands and thousands of things. We don't know the Lexile level. We don't know if it's credible resources or anything like that. So having a place to go where it's separated by grade level, we know that it's credible, and we know that we can build our curriculum, and we know that it's Common Core, that's what we're really excited about.
Publishers don't always get what my class needs. They might have an ideal class in their mind and think this is what my students are going to want, but in reality, that's not what they need. So I can go into the Digital Library and look for lessons that will address what this group of kids needs this year. And so after I teach a lesson, or I have to pre-teach or front load a lesson, the Digital Library is a great resource for me to go into and find something that will actually deliver to this group of kids that I have right now.
I liken the library within the filtering that you can look for subject-specific lessons. So as a literacy coach, I'm supporting science and history teachers implement the literacy standards. I was not a science teacher, but I can go there and learn about how other teachers from across the nation are implementing literacy standards within science curriculum.
So the digital library also has little pieces in there where if you find that you have a specific segment of your group, the EL students, or if you have special needs students, there are lessons in there specifically that you can search for your special populations of students. Many of our lessons were addressed specifically with the universal designs for learnings.
The significance of the digital library is astronomical for the impact it can really have in the instructional program in K-12.